إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم. ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم ولا خمسة إلا هو سادسهم ولا أدنى من ذلك ولا أكثر إلا هو معهم أينما كانوا ثم ينبئهم بما عملوا يوم القيامة، إن الله بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى dear brothers dear sisters asking الله سبحانه وتعالى the way he brought us together in the masjid today to bring us all together in the day of judgment يا رب العالمين في جنة الفردوس الأعلى. اللهم أمين أمين يا أرحم الراحمين. To many of us would like to be good Muslims. Too many of the brothers would like to make tawbah, would love to come to the masjid. Too many of the sisters that love to pray and to wear the hijab and to stop doing ma'asi and the zinub, subhanAllah. Islam is telling us too many ways to follow the right path, Sirat al-Mustaqim. The way we are reciting the Holy Quran day and night, 5 times every day and night, Surah Al-Fatiha, 17 times you are saying and reading, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. One of these ways, الصحبة الصالحة, a good friend, brother and sisters. The friendship, it's very, very important in Islam. When you have someone in your life, to take you from your hand to the door of Jannah, not to take you to the door of the hellfire. فالصاحب ساحب. صاحب, he can drag you from your hand to both ways, either to Jannah or the hellfire. والعياذ بالله. علي الجارم, Lebanese poet, he said, إذا جريت في خلق دنية فأنت ومن تجاريه سواء. رأيت الحر يجتنب المخازي ويحميه عن الغدر وفاء. Tell me who's your friend, I can tell you who you are. Yes, I can know you through your friend. Your friend, as I said, he can take you to the Jannah والعزب, inshallah, or to the hellfire. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us about the importance of the friendship, a good friend in Islam, and the etiquettes of that friend. قال لا تصاحب إلا مؤمنا ولا يأكل طعامك إلا تقي. Your friend, the one who comes to your house, he must be a mu'min, a believer, good Muslim. And they said, ولا يأكل طعامك إلا تقي. The one who's coming to your house. And your friend outside, he must be a mu'min. All of us, young and old, brother or sisters, we are in need to a good friend. Good friend can make your life full of contentment, happiness, sa'ada in this dunya. And you can be a friend to someone, he's full of negativity. More you sit with him, more he's gonna get all in ahzan, the problems he's gonna put it of the world, he's gonna put it above your shoulder every time you sit with him. What kind of friend is? You don't need him. You don't need even to talk to him, even to see his face. We don't have time for this. Somebody sick in his mind, negative. When you sit with him, he makes you sick. You don't need this kind of person. Our life is very short. You don't have time for that. You have to sit with somebody positive, If he will not benefit you, he will not harm you. There is no harm from him. Even if there is no benefits from him, it's okay. But there is no harm. That's very important. الصاحب ثلاثة. Your friends are three types. Number one, somebody متدين, somebody good. He knows Allah, who knows the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That one, follow him. Hold his, grab him from his clothes. Don't leave him alone. He must be with you. That person, subhanAllah, if you are away from Allah, he will bring you back. If you forget, he will remind you. If you go in different direction, he will bring you back to Allah Azza wa Jalla's way. That kind of Muslim, good mu'min, stay with him, stuck with him. Don't leave him. SubhanAllah, where to confine these people? In the masajid. Look at the masjid, look to Salat al-Jama'ah, especially those who are coming to Salat al-Fajr and the Salat al-Asha in Jama'ah. These people, they are not munafiqeen. Who said? Rasulullah. The one who's attending Salat al-Fajr in Jama'ah and Salat al-Asha, they are not munafiqeen. They are not hypocrite people. This is what Rasulullah said. Second type of friend, somebody disobedient to Allah, fajr, rebellious, asi, the brother of shaitan. This person, he can drag you, gurrak like this, to be a sinner like him, to the way of shaitan like him. You're going to the masjid, said, hey, well, masjid for what? Let's go to the bar. You're going to read Quran, don't say, hey, salah, عمل لك كده, subhanAllah. Somehow, he will take you to the different direction. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is giving us a good example about these two types of people. He said, the good friend, like somebody is giving you perfume, or he sell it to you, or he gift it to you. Whenever you be around him, you're going to smell something good, or you can buy something from him, that perfume. And the sahib is so, the bad one, he's like the blacksmith. You sit around him, you're going to smell something bad, might be he's going to burn your clothes too. Be away from him. Be away from him. And that kind of friend, number three, he's not bad, but he is heedless. غافل. مش عارف وين الله حطه. سلبي, negative. Like the people of Al-A'raf. We have long surah, the chapter of the heights, surah Al-A'raf. In the whole entire surah has a mihwar column, the main point of the surah, surah Al-A'raf. It's a Makki chapter, the chapter of the heights. The heights, it's a place between Jannah and the hellfire. Those whom their sayyat, bad deeds and good deeds will be equal. La ilaha illallah. Imagine that. If somebody making one sin, it will be one sin in his record. Might be Allah will forgive it. If somebody make one hasana, Allah will multiply it to 10 and 700 and more. And these people, they came to Allah, will their hasanat and sayyat equal. What? Means they never make any good deeds. The kharbaneen. How one sin can defeat 700 hasana? And he's coming to Allah while he is hasanat equal to his sayyat. Means they were kharbaneen, negative people. And if you read the surah, the whole entire surah, you can understand that. The people of the heights, Al-A'raf, the place, very high place between Jannah and Hellfire. These people, they will be in hold. They will be on hold for 50,000 years until Allah will finish his judgment between people, and they're still waiting like this. No Jannah, no Hellfire. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will finish his judgment with them. Why? Because they were not bad. They were negative people. And Allah said, when you come to the Islam, Ya Yahya, خذ الكتاب بقوة. When you come to the Islam, stand, be strong, carry your deen. I'm going to pray. Maybe yes, maybe not. I give zakat. Forget about sadaqah. Forget about masjid. Selby, negative. He doesn't want to do nothing. Dead people. These people, they have no hasanat in the day of judgment. Even if they are not doing something bad, but they are not good. You don't need this kind of people. They will not help you. Look for somebody good to carry you. To carry you. That's why Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when the Sahaba, they migrated from Mecca to Medina, what happened to them? He said, you are brothers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةِ. And he made مُؤَخَاهُ between المهاجرين والأنصار. Somebody strong from Medina, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, he looked for somebody weak from Mecca.
brother this will brother carry him. The strong will carry the weak one. The rich will give to the poor one. This is how this is the Rasul Asim, he made it like that. It is not a fun or a joke. When he said المؤخاه between المهاجرين والأنصار are brothers, means the strong will carry the weak. The rich will carry the poor. This is how Rasulullah made it. For the whole entire society to carry each other. But to go somebody negative in your life, you are already weak, he will weaken you. You will be weak like him. Might be your brain, you're gonna stop brain one day. That's why you have to know where to go and who is your friend. Brothers, when somebody starts disobeying Allah or making sin or haram in his life, something is not good. And suddenly, like this, he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing comes itself. You're like, subhanAllah, there is no smoke without fire, right? Nothing comes suddenly like this. If somebody is disobeying Allah, look behind, you're going to see somebody behind this person. He is the one who caused him to do that. SubhanAllah, psychological also, it's correct. يعني SubhanAllah, علم نفس. But that's why there is a khid, there is a thread behind this. Why this man killing this person? Why he drink al-khamr? Why he lost his money? Why he is in this big problem? Because there is a thread, there is something behind that. SubhanAllah. حتى وكلاء النيابة والناس اللي بيحددوا في ال crimes and all of that, they knew this. How to get the criminal? They look for all the ways. Somehow they will find the thread. And they follow it. They will find, they get him. This is a way, subhanAllah. There is no smoke without fire. If somebody fasted, corrupt, there is somebody behind him. That's why be aware, open your eyes, especially with your children, those who are growing up in this country. SubhanAllah, you have to watch them. You have to see who it's subhanAllah, about their friends and those who are around them. I have an example here can declare that my point that happened during the time of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah Azza wa Jalla sent Quran talks about this incident. What happened? A man, whenever Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to read the Quran around the Kaaba, that man, he used to go to spy, to listen to the recitation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the Quran. And sometimes he used to tear. Tears comes out from his eyes because he used to listen to the recitation of Rasulullah, Al-Quran al-Kareem, alayhi salatu wasalam. And one day, his heart, subhanAllah, was soft. Allah softened his heart. And he went to Rasulullah and said, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Muhammad, would you please come to my house? I have some food for you. Rasulullah, he did not need his food. He said, what about if you become a Muslim? Say, La ilaha illallah, first we'll talk. And he said, if I say, La ilaha illallah, and you're going to come to my house to eat my food? He said, yes. Rasulullah does not mean if somebody non-Muslim don't eat his food. No, you can eat his food. But Rasulullah did that because he wanted him to come to Islam. Maybe somebody asked me, is there any Christian or Jewish or somebody invite me to his food? And he said, Sheikh said, no. Now go eat. It's okay. He's your neighbor. He gives you food, something. It's okay. If it is halal, yeah, it's okay. I'm talking about the Christian and Jewish. Others, no, don't eat their zabiha or something like that. That's different. Even some of us who are not eating the Christian or Jewish zabiha. وطبعا different opinion between the scholars. I eat it. I say Bismillah and I eat it because it's clear in the Quran. Okay, if it is not dead. The point here is that man, his name was Uqbah ibn Abi Mu'ayt. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was eating his food. The man, he became a Muslim and he said the shahada. And khalas, he's a Muslim. The man was going to his way to Jannah, subhanAllah. His friend, Kharban, Umayyah ibn Khalaf. He was traveling for some trade or business. He came back. First, Arab people, they used to love their friends so much. Even before he got to his house, he went to his friend's house to ask about him. Where is my friend Uqbah, Umayyah? They are the big people of Mecca. She said, your friend Saba. Saba in Arabic means he changed the religion of his parents. That's meaning of Saba. He said, where is he? He's with Muhammad around the Kaaba, alayhi salatu wasalam. Since Uqba starts seeing his friends coming from far, Umayyah, and he was jumping, was running towards him. Give me a hug, man, welcome back. And said, no, go away from me. I don't want to even touch you.
said, why? Said, I heard you sabat. You changed your religion. He said, yes, I did. He said, خلاص, you're not my friend anymore. He said, what should I do? He said, go right now. I want you to chuck Muhammad from his clothes like this, carry him and spit on his face and tell him, I'm not with you anymore. He did. He did. That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he called him, he gave him a name, أشقى القوم, the miserable amongst these people. He was a miserable man, Rasulullah called him. And he died. And he died in the Battle of Badr. They killed him. That's Uqba ibn Abi Mu'ayt. Subhanallah. His daughter, Umm Kulthum, she immigrated. She followed Rasulullah 24 years. Girl, the daughter of this guy, she immigrated after Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, the Treaty of al-Hudaybiyah, to Medina alone. Alone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Quran surah for her, the daughter of this kharban man. Her name is Umm Kulthum, Surah al-Mumtahina. Because when they make the treaty of al-Hudaybiyah, they tried to return her back to Mecca. It was in the treaty. If somebody comes from Mecca Muslim, let him go back to Mecca. And she did. And Allah sent the Quran and said, no, don't return her back to al-Kuffar. That's why from this ayat, it is not permissible for a Muslim woman to marry a non-Muslim. From this surah. Read the last ayat in this surah. Somebody asked him, ya Shaykh, is it permissible for a Muslim woman to marry a Muslim? I said, no. Big no. I will never gonna do that. He must say shahada first if you want to be a Muslim. To give your daughter or your sister to somebody non-Muslim, it's not permissible in Islam. From Surah Al-Mumtahina, it is in the Holy Quran. And who did marry her? Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, one of the kibar al-sahab. He married her. Umm Kulthum, the daughter of Uqba ibn Abi Mu'ayt, this kafir man. Subhanallah. For the point is shahid, subhanallah, that man one time, Uqba, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was praying around the Kaaba. Look at his bad friends. They said, somebody slaughtered his camel and Muhammad is praying right there. Who's amongst us will carry the intestines of this camel, the filth and the stuff, the urine and the intestines of the camel and put it above the shoulder of Muhammad while he was praying. That man, he jumped, he said, I am the one who's going to do it. Uqba, the same one. He was carrying all of this filth where Rasulullah was prostrating, making sujood, he put it behind his shoulder, above his shoulder. أشقى القوم, Rasulullah was so mad. And he was appointing to each one of them, these bad friends around the Kaaba, Uqba, Jahl, Shayba, Rabi'a, they were sitting just in the nadi of Mecca to make fun of Rasulullah and the Sahab, and to torture them in the streets of Mecca. And the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was so mad, and they said, إِنَّمَا جِئْتُكُمْ بِالذَّبْحِ. You, I'm going to slaughter you one day. That's it. They make like this. Because they knew Rasulullah, if you say something done, halas. They knew that. Sadiq al-Amin, alayhi salatu wasalam. All of them, including Uqba, they've been killed in the Battle of Badr. See? So that's why, brothers, we need the youth, shabab, listen to your parents. If your parents, they are giving you advice, don't go with this girl, don't go with this boy, don't be a friend of this, you have to listen. Because they knew, you don't know. And they love you, but you don't know too. That's why they're warning you. Your friend can save you also. How? During the time of Hijrah, migration to from Mecca to Medina, Umar ibn al-Khattab, you know, how he was carrying his sword and he was going around the Kaaba, looking to this kuffar, shahat al-wujuh. Each time he used to make tawaf, he used to spit on their face. If any one of you, I'm going, hey, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they had themselves when they immigrated. Umar, no. Umar was carrying his sword and he said, if any one of you want his mom to lose him and to his kids to be orphaned, follow me behind this valley. I am migrating. And he took 20 sahabi with him to defend them. Umar alone, radiallahu anhu arda. One of them, a man, his name was Ayyash ibn Abi Rabi'ah. Ayyash ibn Abi Rabi'ah was migrating with Umar under the protection of Umar, radiallahu anhu. And Abu Jahl, he saw Ayyash and he said, man, your mom is very sick. Look, he was very clever, Abu Jahl. Stupid. What he did, said, your mom is very sick. How can you leave your mom and you go with Umar and Muhammad, al-Salam to al-Madina? And Sayyidina Umar said, ya Ayyash, don't believe this man. This man is kharban. Don't listen to him. He said, no. Your mom is sick. Stay with her in Mecca. Don't go with him. Look, subhanAllah, shayateen.
And سيدنا عمر said, no, 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 no. If your mom is sick, سبحان الله, and أوجعها الحر, if it is so hot and this, كذا, she's gonna take shower and she's gonna sit under the shade. She will be okay. Don't worry about your mom. She will be okay. عمر is telling عياش. And عياش, أبو جهل was like السحر, يعني الزن على السحر. Talking. And they said, your mom. These people, they used to have loyalty and they used to have honor to their parents. And سبحان الله, what happened is, he listened to أبو جهل. And سيدنا عمر was very smart. He said, listen to me. This is my she camel, ناقة. Take it with you. One day, ride it and come to المدينة. سيدنا عمر just, he want to leave something with him just to send him, give me my ناقة back just to drag him to المدينة again. You're playing smart, أبو جهل, again I play smart too with you, سيدنا عمر. And سبحان الله, one time, later, he called عياش or he sent a message to him, where is my ناقة? Where is my she camel? I need my she camel. And he sent this, and he said to Umar, he sent him a message. I am very sorry, and I am asking Allah forgiveness for me that I was not coming with you to Mecca. Later he was telling him that. And Sayyidina Umar told him this ayah in the Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفُرِ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Huh? Say to my servants, those who despair, those who give up, Allah's mercy, do not do it. Do not do it. Allah is the Ghafoor Rahim. Come back. And subhanAllah, somehow at night he sneaked behind them and he was riding the Naqa, the she camel of Umar, and he went to Medina and he followed them to Medina al-Munawwara. See, your friend like Umar al-Khattab can save you from the hellfire, can give you advice, can help you. That's why, subhanAllah. You know the authentic hadith of that man? He killed 99 people, from that man from Bani Israel. He killed 99 people. Long story. He asked for tawbah. I want to make tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Even killing 99 people, yes. They asked him, go to that man. There is a monk in this city or this village. Go ask him. Maybe he will give you fatwa for tawbah. He went to the monk. That monk just will shiver. He's not a scholar. Is there any tawbah, repentance for me? He said, no. Did you kill 99 people? Get out of here. There is no tawbah. Allah will never gonna forgive you. One word from him, one word from that monk, he get his sword and he finish the monk too. He made it 100, mashallah. He finished him. Subhanallah. After a while, that man, he's from Bani Israel, that story, Rasulullah mentioned it. After a while, that man, he said, I'm killing people. What is the end? What is the end? I'm gonna die. Allah will count me for this. Asked him, go, there is a scholar, somebody alim. Go ask him, he's gonna give you fatwa. Said, man, I killed 100 people. Is there any repentance, tawbah, forgiveness for me? Said, yes, you're still alive. Who can stop you from tawbah? And they said, but listen to me. Look at this is the point of the hadith. Listen to me. I want you to leave all of that area where you live. It's very bad people around you. Change the atmosphere, that society where you live, there is a certain village, so and so, he named it to him, pious people, good people there, live with them. And Allah will accept your tawbah. That man in the end, he died in the middle of the way. Malaikat al-Rahma, Malaikat al-Azab, Malaikat of Jannah and Fire, they've been disputing. This man, he never made hasana, and he killed 100 people. And the Malaikat al-Rahma, they said, but he make tawbah, and he died before his tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was judging between them, he took him to Jannah. Maybe somebody gonna kill me, Sheikh, but he killed this people. They have rights. Allah will take care of these rights for him in the day of judgment. Allah will satisfy him that. Allah will cover him up in the day of judgment because he did tawbah. That's why make tawbah. Don't delay your tawbah. Ask Allah for forgiveness all the time. Whatever you did, Alhamdulillah, he did not kill 90 people or 100 people, right? Alhamdulillah, we're not killers, we're Muslims. The religion of peace. That's why, brothers, if you have bad friend, be away from him. And the good friend, he can give advice. Allah created us to live with each other, to be united, to come together. If I see my brother, he needs nasiha, advice, I will advise him. This is some of the etiquettes of the friendship in Islam. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was telling Rasulullah, ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يريدون وجهه ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا. سبحان الله. يا محمد
Those who are staying, the fuqara, the poor of the sahaba, stay with them. Those who are invoking Allah in the morning and the evening, stay with these people. Support them. Be with them. Subhanallah. That's why very important, brothers. The scholar, they said, stay around as-salihin, those who are pious, the mu'mineen. Why? Allah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the mercy to them, even if you are not salih like them, some mercy will touch you. You're going to get portion of this mercy. But if you are salih and you are pious, you are good around the bad ones, might be Allah will punish them and you're going to get portion of the punishment too. Stay with the salihin. Don't go away from them. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, people will be enemy to each other in the day of judgment. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتْ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ. Allah is telling Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, you shall die and they will follow you. And in the day of judgment, you're going to be enemy to each other. Ya Rabbi, he took my money. He took my hasanat. He talked about my honor. He shed my blood. He killed me. He did this. He did this. People will have animosity for everybody in need to one hasana, good deed in the day of judgment. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this ayah in the Quran, except المتقون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الأخلاء بعضهم يومئذ لبعض عدو إلا المتقين. The friends will be enemy to each other in the day of judgment, except the muttaqeen, those who have the piety and the fear of Allah. المتقون, they will intercede for each other in the day of judgment. Dear brothers, subhanallah, be around the mu'mineen. Maybe you're going to have one of these brothers in the masjid. He said, Ya Rab, this man, I know him. He used to come to receive the masjid one day. Ya Rab, I ask you for forgiveness for him. You never know. Yes, we have too many intercessions. It started first with the intercession of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the salihin, the mu'mineen, the hafiz al-Quran, the martyrs, and the mu'mineen, and the anbiya, and the sahaba, and the salihin from your family and your friends. If you have a friend, he's a mu'min, he can intercede for you. If you are in trouble in the day of judgment, he will say, Ya Rabbi, he's my friend. Get him out from the hellfire. You never know. Subhanallah. That's why very important to think about that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, me, you will see me, he's telling the sahab. In the day of judgment, you will see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entering al-Jannah, Abu Bakr in his right side and Umar in his left side. And he's putting his arm above both of them like this. Three of them, they're going to enter Jannah together like that. Suhbah. That's why, even when they immigrated to Medina, he said, Ya Abu Bakr, Suhba, Ya Abu Bakr, you're my friend. You're going to be my sahib. We're going to go together for Hijrah, Ya Abu Bakr. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran. Abu Bakr, in the cave, he said, Ya Rasulullah, the kuffar, they are surrounding the cave. If any one of them going to look under his foot, he will see us. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَتَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. Rasulullah was telling his sahib, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, don't be sad. Allah with us. Allah with us. See, إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لِصَاحِبِهِ فَالصُحْبَ الصُحْبَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ. Dear brothers, very important to think about that. Love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love those who are coming to the masajid. الصُحْبَ الصُحْبَ. In the day of judgment, subhanallah, one of the seven types of Muslims will be under the shade of Allah. Rajulan, two men, two brothers, two sisters. They love each other for the sake of Allah. That will cause them to be under the shade of Allah in the day of judgment. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون توبوا إلى الله واستغفروا. الحمد لله رب العالمين.